Welcome back to the portfolio, everyone. And today I'm going over the six stocks I'm going to buy this week. All six of these stocks are at the top of my watch list. And why I'm looking at these stocks this week is because every single one of them reports earnings this week. And usually when companies report earnings, there's a little bit of fluctuation with share price. And of course, that may lead to great buying opportunities, as well as good earnings may lead to share increases, which means there is positivity and good outlook for the company moving forward. So today I have a combination of dividend payers and growth stocks on this list. These dividend payers, I believe, can be part of a nice overall diversified portfolio, and they do provide long-term blue chip company exposure. So I'm going to jump right into the top six picks. Before I do that, I am going to ask you to please hit that like button and subscribe. I am the Gen Z investor, and every single day I come up with new videos that talk about different stocks you can buy, the overall stock market, and overall big stock market news and headlines. Current financial freedom portfolio value is just over $46,000. Current value at $46,350. Friday, we ended the week on a nice gain of over $600 in the one-day chart. Overall portfolio is still down over 10%, but I do believe they will come back over the long term. I keep collecting those dividends and I keep reinvesting the dividends. So we'll jump right into this list. And the first stock I have on my watch list this week is Pepsi. Very close to becoming a dividend king, ticker symbol PEP, currently trading at $134 a share. So Pepsi reports earnings on Monday, and I do really like this company, and I do believe they're going to continue to thrive over the long term. If you take a look on the one-year chart, they are flat, barely any price fluctuations over the past 1 year. They have recovered from the pre-pandemic levels, but have not reached any new time highs, which may make this a nice buying opportunity. Massive market cap at $186 billion. And of course, why I like Pepsi is because they are extremely diversified. They own so many different brands outside of just the soft drink company. They own, of course, a bunch of different drinks and a lot of other snack brands. And of course, they have some interest in some consumer everyday brands as well. If we take a look at that dividend, because of course, dividend is extremely important when it comes to Pepsi. Very nice 3% starting yield right now. Payout ratio around 76%. So a little bit on the high side. Beautiful 5-year dividend growth rate around 8.4%. And they're extremely close to becoming a dividend king with a 48-year dividend growth streak. And I am sure over the next 2 years, they will continue to increase their dividend and become a dividend king and reach that amazing 50-year dividend growth streak. The second stock on my list reports earnings on July 14th. This is JP Morgan Chase, still trading below $100 at $96 a share. This is the largest US banks with a market cap just shy of $300 billion. And if you take a look on the one-year chart, they are still down 15%, which I believe this makes it a great buying opportunity for my personal portfolio. Because it has not recovered from pre-pandemic levels, I do personally believe there's a little bit of upside coming with JP Morgan. And of course, with all the turmoil and the economic slowdown we're going through right now, bank stocks are under a lot of pressure, but I do believe JP Morgan will be able to weather the storm and continue to grow over the long term. With regard to their dividend, who is still up in the air right now, current yield around 3.74%, very nice 66% payout ratio, and beautiful 5-year dividend growth rate of over 16%. And they have been growing that dividend for the past 10 years. Of course, the dividend payment is a little bit up in the air right now because of how the government mandates. JP Morgan right now currently can continue to pay out the same dividend rate, but they may cut it in the short term. That doesn't really scare me away from this company too much because I do believe in them long term, and I do believe they will continue to grow and reestablish that dividend once the economy begins to pick up and growth continues to come in from all businesses. The third stock on our list is a growth stock that does pay a tiny little bit of a dividend, which is Domino Pizza, currently trading at $398 a share. So I consider this more of a growth stock because the dividend yield is only at 0.78%. So you're getting a very low minimal dividend with regard to Domino's. If we take a look on the 1 year, they are up 44%, and they have seen huge growth over the past 5 years, up over 243%. With regard to that little dividend, they do pay that 0.78% dividend with a 27% payout ratio, so very low payout ratio, very sustainable dividend. And of course, when it comes with a low yield, they have been growing it very nicely at over 21% per year on the 5-year average, with of course a 7-year dividend growth streak. So Domino's is of course a play right now with a lot of people staying home, not really going out to restaurants to eat, a lot of people ordering food to their homes. Domino's may see some nice earnings over this past 3 months. It'll be interesting to see how their earnings come out. The fourth stock on our list that I'm looking at this week is another financial stock. It is Bank of America, the second largest American bank. And if you take a look at the market cap at over $200 billion, very similar price chart to JP Morgan, down 17% on the 1 year chart. And similar to JP Morgan, they have not recovered to pre-pandemic levels, which personally I believe gives us a lot of upside potential moving forward. Once again, their dividend yield of around 3% may be up in the air with regard to this, how the economic slowdown is occurring. But of course, this Bank of America, I do believe in them long term. And if you need to bump up your financial sector, or if you want to look into some research, some companies, I think the two stocks in the financial sector I have on my list this week, JP Morgan and Bank of America, are good ones you can take a look at. With regard to that 3% dividend that they are still currently paying out, they have that nice 3% yield, 48% payout ratio, so extremely sustainable payout ratio. Insane 5-year dividend growth rate, but they have only been growing that dividend for 4 years. They did have to cut the dividend and then they reestablished it, but weren't growing it each and every year. And now they have been growing it, but of course, for only 4 years. So not a strong dividend growth history. But of course, I do believe this company has the fundamentals to live through this economic turmoil and continue to grow over the long term. Stock number 5 on our list of stocks that I'm taking a look at this week is, of course, the beast, Johnson & Johnson, the household name brand. They own so many different products and operate within the healthcare sector, an extremely, extremely large company at a market cap of over $375 billion. On the one-year price chart, you can see they're flat once again, barely up 1% on the 1 year. They have fully recovered from pre-pandemic levels, and of course, they are a little bit on a downward trend right now, which is okay. 52-week chart, you can see low end of $109 a share, but on the high end at $157 a share. So somewhat near the middle on the 52-week chart. This is, of course, a solid, solid dividend company. If we take a look at their dividend scorecard, you can see a 57-year dividend growth history, meaning they are a dividend king. They've been growing that dividend for over 57 years. That nice 2.84% solid starting yield. And of course, with a payout ratio of only 52%, they have a lot of money left to reinvest back in the business to grow operations. And of course, they have enough money to continue that grow that dividend moving forward. And a beautiful 5-year dividend growth rate at 6%, meaning you're getting a nice starting yield at 2.8 with a beautiful dividend growth rate. Your dividends are compounding very nicely year over year. And this dividend is extremely safe in my opinion. I don't believe Johnson & Johnson will cut their dividend anytime soon. They have the strong financials. They are growing revenue year over year. And of course, with this such low payout ratio, there is a lot of room to move that dividend up at the same rate long into the future. That 57-year dividend growth history is extremely hard to operate. It's extremely hard to get to that point. I do not believe they're going to sacrifice and lose that streak anytime soon. The fifth and final stock on our list this week is Netflix. Netflix is a growth play. They do not pay a dividend. So you can see here, no dividend yield. This company is one of the FANG stocks, which I've mentioned in a previous video. I believe Netflix has a lot of growth potential, still upside. And of course, depending on how their earnings come out this week, maybe we see a little dip and it might be a nice buying opportunity. So Netflix trades under ticker symbol NFLX, over $548 a share right now. On the one-year chart, you can see they are up 44%. So they have grown very high past their pre-pandemic levels. If we take a look at the five-year chart, absolute insane number here, up 464% on the five-year chart. 5 years ago, a share in Netflix was trading around $100, now up to $550 a share. And they are trading right near their 52-week high right now. But of course, if you see a lot of potential in Netflix over the long term, then even though it's at that all-time high, you may be a nice buying opportunity. Any of these companies on this list today, they are all blue chip household names. There's nothing speculative on this list. These are companies where if you invest your hard-earned money into them, you really hope they're going to grow long-term and you hold your money for 5, 10, 15 plus years. And you know these companies are continue to cash flow year in and year out and return capital back to investors through dividends, share buybacks, or capital appreciation. And over time, you're going to invest your money with a little bit of less stress. You're not throwing your money into anything super speculative where you don't know if your money's going to come out on top. These are all solid companies that I have at the top of my watch list this week. So of course, those are the stocks I'm looking at this week. And I am the Gen Z investor. And like I said, I post videos every single day on this channel that talk about the stock market, different stocks you can buy in different sectors and different markets, overall stock market performance, and any big news headlines or big market outcomes. Like I'm sure this week we're going to post videos that talk about how these companies performed and how their financials came out and their financial statements and see how they performed in Q2. Q2, we did see a lot of economic shutdown. There was a lot of businesses who were completely shut down. A lot of stores, workers, people were living from home. People weren't out there spending a lot of money. So it's going to be very interesting to go through and see how these different companies who all operate in different sectors actually performed during that economic shutdown. And of course, any other big market news headlines. We will make videos about them, discuss. Please leave your thoughts in the comment below and like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in tomorrow's video. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.